Hellos, everyone, and I'm here with my co-host Brendan, and we are here doing two Walking Dead episodes today, Season 6, Episode 15, East, and Season 6, Episode 16, Last Day on Earth.
I'm in pain.
And we are in pain. And we are in pain. So much pain.
So many people are hurt. People are hurt. Somebody like dead.
Yeah.
No, don't do that. I need that one.
Okay. So let's start off with the East episode. So first topic is Carol and Tobin, that little relationship that has, I don't even know it's gonna go anywhere.
I don't care.
Yeah.
I don't care. Carol's on this downward emotional spiral. She's just heading out. I don't care what happens with Tobin. I don't know Tobin. And Tobin's just like, hey, I'ma put my dick in it. And that's what this relationship is. I don't care. I just don't. Carol's the homie who's been there since the beginning. I don't care about Tobin. And now that she's leaving, their relationship's gonna go south. I don't care.
Yes, I care because I want Carol to be happy, but I don't at the same time because we don't know who Tobin really is. So.
Okay, no matter. I don't care.
Alright, so next will be Carol herself in this episode. That whole scene with her and those saviors, that was so fast.
Carol herself, in terms of her actions, she's a savage. In terms of what's going on, her, she just needs to be picked up, cradled, and she needs to be put in a cradle. Just put in a cradle and rocked to sleep. So she doesn't have to feel hurt anymore.
Remember,
not at night, go to sleep.
The thing a lot of people have been saying about Carol, they think that her sudden transformation is just out of nowhere. Because she went from, I don't agree with them, but I understand what they're saying. Because she went from, like, she did all these awful things and she really didn't really shed a tear about it. I mean, she was sad, like what happened with Lizzie and Mika. She cried, but it really didn't affect her at that time with Carol and, not Carol, those two people she burned in the prison. I can't remember the names right now.
Tyrese's bang.
Yes.
Other nigga.
Yeah. She wasn't sad about that at all. She did what she had to do. With all those wolves that she killed, she did what she had to do. And I feel like that it's all catching up to her. That's why I understand what people are saying it's out of the blue. It's not out of the blue. She's been holding in this emotions for so long, and now it's finally coming out because she realized that, holy shit, I'm killing these people, and I feel really bad about it.
That's all it is.
It's
not that it's coming out of nowhere. It just didn't hit her until now. It's build up. There's all that. When you're self-consciously killing, just killing, you keep telling yourself, it's to survive. I'm doing this to survive. I'm doing this to protect my people. I'm doing this to survive. Now Carol's getting to a point where she's realizing a big chunk of the people that she killed, she didn't have to kill.
Mm-hmm.
And she's finally feeling sorry for it, repenting for it. Because she's finally been backed into a corner for once in her life.
Mm-hmm.
And she realizes that she feels as though since she is now mentally unable to kill the way she did before, she feels as though she is of no use to the group. Which is why she ran away. Me personally, I think it makes sense. Gradual slow descent. She needs a hug. Maybe a little high chair, some apple juice, just something to go and chill the fuck out. Something.
All right. Well, that was Carol in this episode. We'll get to Carol next episode eventually. So Maggie and Glenn, that shower scene, that was awesome. But also in that shower scene,
Maggie, god damn,
Glenn realizes the bruises on her back from when that dude was kicking her. That could result in a possible miscarriage for
Maggie? Could result in a miscarriage, could result in some minor back pain. It's the Walking Dead. You never fucking know.
True.
Just, for all we know, it's just a flesh wound. And she'll be alright the very next day. He noticed the marks. He was looking at the marks. I wasn't.
Honestly, to be
100% honest, I kind of, you're sitting here talking about marks. I'm like, there were marks on her back? I wasn't even looking. I was like, there were marks on her back?
I noticed some marks on her back, obviously.
I noticed her backside. Was there marks on her back? I didn't even look at her back like that. I was just like, oh, god damn. But my manly nature's aside. These two. A lot of people are saying that Glenn and Maggie are relationship goals. I can somewhat understand why. My only issue with those relationship goals is that, can we not have this relationship while people are dying?
Yeah.
We can have a relationship and get fucked. We can cuddle under the moonlight. Just, can we not have kids? Can we not have kids in a zombie? That's a set of problems.
I was just about to say something. I'm not gonna bring it up now.
That's a set of problems.
So Abraham, Sasha, and Rosita. That whole up triangle. Rosita's so butthurt. She is so butthurt. But I understand. I would be too.
Rosita is mad. She's angry. Rosita is so mad.
Not only did she witness someone...
She's so angry.
Not only did she witness someone that could possibly have been her best friend die in front of her, but now she just lost the only dude that she probably ever cared about.
She's upset.
To a family member, because they are all a family.
She's upset because this beautiful mustachioed white man that she snatched up left her for a packaging of chocolate.
That's exactly what happened.
When the man leaves that Spanish buffet table for that chocolate fountain on the other side of the room, and the person who made the buffet is mad because ain't nobody eating. That's where Rosita's at right now.
Rosita will be okay.
Rosita's bad. She'll be fine.
Yeah,
she's a gorgeous woman.
There's Spencer.
He's a good... There's Spencer. How much of a downgrade from Abraham that is?
I mean, Spencer is cute.
He ain't shit. You know Spencer ain't shit.
I like Spencer. We'll get to that.
I look at Spencer the same way I look at Tobin. Don't care. I don't care about any of these Alexandria niggas. The only two that I give a fuck about are Aaron and Denise.
You didn't even know his name,
and
nigga.
Denise is dead.
You didn't even know his name.
I didn't, but I knew he was relevant enough for me to somewhat care when he was around. I just forgot his name because he wasn't around as often to speak it.
True.
Denise was around. Aaron was around. The dude with the dreadlocks, what's his name again?
Heath.
Heath.
Oh my god, speaking of Heath, they're still out there.
Heath and Tara are still out who knows where. In Bumblefuck, Georgia.
I hope they address that next season. Because the fact that they even come back at all, I thought they were going to be part of the finale, but they weren't.
Watch Heath come back, but then Tara's head's like on a pipe or some shit.
No!
At least she won't have to come back and find out that Denise is dead.
She can move on from that.
She'll already be with her. Move on to who? Rosita? Rosita, I love you, but I like Dick.
There are plenty of other people in the world. Like the people
we... Are there?
We met
a... This is a zombie apocalypse. How many other people there are?
We're going to get to that in the next episode. Damn it, I have a lot to say in that next episode. I'm trying to fast forward this. Rick and Michonne.
I don't care. I'm sorry it seems like I don't give a crap about all these relationships, but it's like... Other than Maggie and Glenn. And even with Maggie and Glenn, nothing's happening. Nothing is happening to forward their relationship. They're together for the... I see your heart. That's just it. This is what I was afraid of them doing. They got together, and now they haven't done shit with it.
They are surviving.
That's
they
great.
Have too many shit going on right now that's for that to great. Happen.
Have a conversation. Ask each other, okay, what is this? What are we now? Are we boyfriend and girlfriend now?
Obviously, they're laying naked in bed eating apple.
First of all, Rosita and Spencer was laying in bed naked too. That don't mean shit. You can lay naked and bone whoever you want in this world. That don't automatically mean you're together. I gotta ask. I got questions. I don't care if they're together. Just give us a reason. They've been together for what? A few episodes now? How many episodes have they been together now? Because it was the mid-season premiere where they started.
Like, not even after that.
When after that? Like one episode or two?
I think two. It was before they met Jesus.
That no, it was that the episode.
It was the episode when they met Jesus, actually.
It was the episode when they first met him. So it was only like episode two.
Right.
It wasn't even that far. And there were how many episodes in and they've still not done or addressed this relationship properly? At all?
I don't know. We'll see what happens in the future.
Like I said, the Maggie and Glenn, when it comes to these relationships, I don't care.
Now we're going to save this one for the very last of this part. Then there's Enid and Maggie. That relationship, I really like that relationship because it's like a, you could either take it as a mother-daughter relationship or a sister relationship.
Enid and Maggie. Enid, sadly, another one of those characters that just don't care. Because they're throwing all these characters at us and not enough of them are getting enough screen time or development for me to give a shit.
True.
Like, okay, Enid, you were there with Glenn for a little bit. What else did you do? Ran around in the woods with Carl's bitch ass for a little bit. What are you gonna do? I say that as a term of endearment. You know Carl is the homie right now. In this season,
as long as you know.
In this season, Carl is the homie.
As long as you know.
We talk about earlier seasons, we won't have to have a discussion. But here, in this season, Carl is the homie. But, I guess the only proper thing I can think of as to why the Enid and Maggie relationship exists is, once again, as per usual, a parallel to the comic. Because in this point in the comic, Sophia, who, as we know, died towards the middle of season 2, mm-hmm. is still alive. And her and Maggie have, like, this mother-daughter relationship going on. Sophia's not here. Somebody else had to fill that spot, so I guess they put Enid there in that spot. That's the only explanation I could come up with. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, it's just like, okay, they're bonding.
I like it.
I don't mind it. It's cute. It's fine. I don't have an issue with it. There's nothing wrong with it.
Now, I wrote down Glenn, but I really don't know why. I can't remember why I wrote down Glenn. I think... Oh, it was his conversation with Daryl, because pretty much let's talk about Daryl. That whole thing. So Daryl goes out to, I thought he was going out to look for Carol, but no, he's going out for revenge against Dwight. That's pretty much why he's going out.
He was going out to try and shoot that boy Dwight right between his eyes. Come at me like, oh, this is just too good. Right between the eyes.
And then he ended up getting captured with Rosita, Michonne, and
ended up getting Glenn. Captured, probably got that shoulder shot a little bit.
Oh, God.
When a bunch of us thought that Daryl might have died for a split second, but then it was just like, shoulder shot. Ah, my life.
I knew he did get shot in the shoulder, because it looked like he did get shot in the shoulder.
I also love how Glenn grinded Daryl the fuck up.
He needed to, because Daryl was not thinking.
He wasn't.
He was being irrational.
But honestly, I find this situation to be beautiful. Mm-hmm. The fact that these two have finally got to a point where they can talk to each other face to face and yell at each other and have it not turn into a severe confrontation. Like, they both just understand each other now. Mm-hmm. Remember back in season 1, Daryl ain't take shit from nobody. Mm-hmm. Especially not Glenn, who in his mind was just a tiny little weakling we didn't give a shit about. Seasons go on. Now he's at a point where he's like, yo, short round and putting up some work. You gotta respect that. You my man's now.
I actually understand why Rosita was going with Daryl too, because
Rosita was going because she was butthurt.
And she did. She was there when she was
going. She was going there because she said she knew where he was going, because she assumed that he was going to the train tracks to look for Dwight, which she was correct about. Mm-hmm. But she was also going because she was butthurt and she didn't want to stay in the camp anymore.
And then the last thing I want to talk about is Rick and Morgan, and this scene was amazing.
Rick and Morgan, the two that started it all.
And fucking Rick almost shot that one dude who is prominent, very important. So thank you, Morgan, for saving that man's life.
Yeah, thanks, Morgan, that guy who saves lives, and that I've been proud of for the past few days.
Hey, look, I already explained to you why I have my issues with Morgan. After this episode, I don't. It's starting to weaken.
I know. It's only starting to get better now. Because you realize, while Morgan's method of saving people can be problematic, Rick's method of shooting everything that moves is even more problematic.
Yes.
That's the only reason why Morgan's getting less slack, because Rick's being even dumber.
Yes.
And as for these two, once again, the two that started it all, it was beautiful to see them go out on a tag team like this.
Mm-hmm.
And then when that whole scene happened, when homie Morgan split off and go off on his own. I hope he don't die.
He's not gonna die anytime soon. Especially like now since he just got promoted as a series regular.
We don't know.
We don't know though. But he wasn't there.
We don't know. I hope he don't die.
Alright, well, we covered the East episode. What I really wanna get to is yesterday's episode. That's what I really wanna get to. Jesus Christ, man.
Fuck!
I'm not even upset anymore about it. I'm just like, because I can't be upset because we even know who it was.
I'm sad. Mad. Sad. I feel betrayed.
A lot of people feel betrayed.
Damn you, Cockman!
Look, I don't. It's gonna pay
W-A-M-C.
off. It's gonna pay off. It's just we have to wait until season 7.
Inhale my dog. Enragement Network.
Alright, let's get to this. So, Carl and Eden. The fact that he locked her in a closet.
I was dying.
I was laughing too. I was like, he's gonna lock her in the closet. He's gonna lock her in the closet. He's gonna lock her in the closet.
First of all, I was laughing because Eden, girl, your stupid ass, who keeps pistols on the floor of the closet?
No one.
Your stupid ass, you believe that, number one. He said, oh yeah, I'm keeping some pistols over there in the closet. You full of shit. If anybody in this whole compound has pistols, they're either gonna be on their person, in a drawer, or in the armory, where everything else is. Who keeps pistols in a closet? A broom closet? A coat closet? You were stupid for believing that, number one. Number two, have you actually tried that chair thing?
No.
I asked my mom about it when we were watching the episode, and she was like, it does work. And I was like, I've never actually done it. I'm really curious.
I'm pretty sure it does work, like, but I've never tried it. Like, not for these doors.
Like, I'm,
but for an like, actual doorknob
really,
door,
really
it probably works.
I'm really curious. Like, I want to get the proper chair and just try and do that.
It probably does work. I don't know.
It probably does. As for these two, this is one of the few little relationship bonding things that are going on that I actually want to see something develop from this.
Me too. Like, I asked her my reaction video. I'm like, are they together? Because I think D asked me, are they together? I'm like, I think so.
They're not. They have not officially called themselves together. They've just hung out.
Okay.
They've just hung out a lot. And a lot of plot points have revolved around these two being together. Okay. However, I really really, this is one of the few times with these couples that are going on in Alexandria, I want this to happen. Carl, you've been through so much shit. You deserve this shit.
And now he's going to be going through even more shit.
Your dad's been getting honeys. The homie Daryl could potentially get honeys.
I hope so.
The bull Glenn got that attractive farm girl. And now you. Abraham been getting Spanish and chocolate on the side.
Get that karma.
Got the Tara.
Got the karma.
Tara, even Tara getting some booty.
Was.
Damn. Why you gotta say that?
Because we know it's true.
We do. Why you have to remind me? Damn. Damn. And then there's you, Carl. Coral. Little Coral. Coral. You grown now. You got a nice looking female right there.
I think they will just.
It's time for you to hug her. Do some cutesy shit. Kiss her on her forehead.
Kiss her. Just kiss her.
Matter of fact, you're old enough. Just kiss her.
Just kiss her.
Right, just smack right on the lips. Hold her hand. Seal the deal. It's over. But don't do what your Uncle Glenn did. Don't fuck up. Protect. Don't be silly. Wrap your willy. Protection is key. Don't. Wrap it in the latex so she don't get to your non-existent zombie apocalypse paychecks. That's how you fuck up in this world.
I fucking can't.
No, this is serious. This is serious.
Okay. Alright, Gabriel.
Gabriel.
Use
it is official. Gabriel, you have officially 100% redeemed yourself.
Use my nigga. Yes, Judith is your number one priority. Yes.
Judith is your number one priority.
They have a plan.
They have a backup plan. This bull.
They got a backup to the backup plan.
This bull is holding this sniper around like it's his baby.
And he's not even wearing his fucking priest outfit anymore.
He's not because.
Amen.
He's killing for the Lord. He's killing for Jesus. Yes, sir. I'm sorry if I offended anyone. That was terrible. But, yeah, he's actually stepping up. He's asking questions.
Yeah.
He's like, do you trust me to actually stand here and do this?
And Rick does trust him.
Well, after what I did before, it's easy to see that you would not fuck with me. Are you sure you want me right here? And he does. It's chilling. And I'm like, alright. Mutual respect. I fucks with that.
Yes.
I fucks with that.
He officially... I mean, I think he redeemed him a few episodes back for me. But, yeah. He's... I love
for me, this is a full sign of redemption. Because you can go with people, and you can kill with people whenever you damn well please. That doesn't automatically make you an ally. You could be with me and kill some shit and then leave. It doesn't automatically make you an ally. Just take it from somebody who's read some of the comics and who has played the Telltale games too much to know that you can kill with this person all the way up till episode 1. That doesn't mean that 4 episodes later, this same nigga's gonna be on your side later. If anything, this same nigga might be trying to be the one asshole trying to kill you. But anyway.
So, Gabriel, you're awesome. Stay awesome, please.
Savage.
Maggie.
Yes.
So pretty much Maggie.
Praise the Lord.
So pretty much Maggie is on. She's really sick. They gotta get her to the hilltop, and she just. Oh my God! Maggie, like.
Two things, Maggie as a character. You're strong as shit, and you need a hug. You just need a hug. Just somebody. Somebody needs to give you a hug and some ginger ale. Just to ease that tummy pain. To ease what the fuck's going on down here.
Because I realized as in the beginning of the episode, she's still in pain, but she looks fine. She's not sweating and shit, and she doesn't look pale. But as the episode goes on, she looks pale, she's sweating, she's in more pain. I'm like, oh my God, like, we need to get her to a fucking doctor.
And as my second point, gotta give points to her actress.
Mm-hmm.
This is the first time that I've seen an actress on TV look sicker than a bitch. and still somehow look gorgeous. How you look sick as a dog
and hot?
How does that work? Is that allowed?
Yeah.
Is that okay?
That is okay.
Is there some sort of written law? You are not allowed to be bad as shit while you sick as a dog. Ruh-ruh. It's just, I don't know, just props to Maggie and all that she's going through. I hope this baby makes it.
I hope so too.
I hope this baby
makes it. By now, the baby has to be a fetus because I don't even know how long she is.
I know, but like, if depending on how sick she is and how severe what she's going through is, I hope the baby makes it out of this. And if the baby does make it out of this, I hope it doesn't have some sort of like mental deficiency or something like that. The last thing you need in a zombie apocalypse is a baby with a mental disorder.
Really?
That's going to cause problems.
But next is Morgan and Carol. That whole thing there. First of all, Carol, why are you pointing a gun at Morgan? He's just trying to help you. This is me saying this. This is me saying this. The person who has gone against Morgan for these past couple episodes. And this is me telling you, why are you pointing a gun at the person who's trying to help you? Stop it. I can see you from the court. Stop it. Why are you pointing a gun at the person who's trying to help you? And why are you leaving? Why are you going away? Like, I understand you want to be alone, but let Morgan help you. All he wants to do is help you. That's it. And yo, I clapped like a motherfucker when he killed that son of a bitch. I was like, yes, Morgan, yes, you killed for the right reasons. Yes, 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 that's all I wanted you to do. That's all I wanted you to do, which is to protect the people you love. That's all.
He's done that before.
He didn't do that with the wolf.
Yeah, that was the one exception.
Yeah, and I didn't like that he did that, and I'm just happy he did it with Carol.
Like, it's not like he's never killed before. He's killed plenty.
Yes, he has. When he didn't have this all life is precious attitude, but when he was fucked up.
How do you just mean that? Like, he's been riding with them, beating the shit and killing niggas regularly. The one person he didn't kill was that one wolf. Other than that,
I did not see Morgan kill anyone.
He's killed plenty of people.
No, I have not seen that at all. I've seen Morgan kill walkers. I have not seen him kill anyone.
He's killed plenty of walkers, and if he hasn't killed people, it's because, honestly, there hasn't been a reason to.
What are you talking about?
Other than the wolf. Other than that one wolf.
Or wolves.
I don't see anyone else doing
no, shit. No! When the fucking, in the second episode of the season, when all those wolves came in, killing people, he did nothing. He let those people go.
What you gonna do? What you gonna do?
The only time Morgan ever killed people was before he met Eastman.
And this is when I smile and look at all those people who were angry at Morgan for not killing people. And then we slowly slide on over to the nigga Grimes. The man who's been doing nothing but killing everybody.
I'm not talking about Rick.
And look at where we are now.
Rick. I'm talking about Morgan.
I know, I am too. It's a parallel, but...
But yes, it is a parallel.
I understand why people can be mad with some of the decisions that Morgan has made. I'm not arguing with that at all.
I'm just happy that instead of... Yes, he did give a dude a chance to leave.
Yo, he did shoot the shit out of them.
He just kept shooting.
Those were all neck shots.
Really?
He shot the shit out of that nigga. I was like, he doesn't have to be this way. Nah, fuck you. I was like, damn.
I was like, oh shit.
Shooting him with the nigga.
I was like, yes.
Damn.
Yes, Morgan.
So what about the Power Rangers?
Bro, I was like, who are these? Warrior looking motherfuckers.
I'm not even mad.
I'm not.
Because in a zombie apocalypse, if I could be decked out like that, I would.
With them spears and them horses. I'm like,
I'm
yes.
I'm not getting bit by
And you know what made me happy? It made me happy because they're not bad people this time. They're good people. They came off as good people.
And so do a lot of other people.
True, but this is... But
I do genuinely believe that they are good people. I genuinely believe
I
genuinely believe that they are good people.
But they, from the comics, I think they are the kingdom.
How fucking
society?
Possibly. I think so. I believe so. I'll have to look more into that. Mm-hmm. But from what we know about Walking Dead as a whole, people can seem nice all the time. People can show up nice all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's their bullshit. Oh, it turns out I'm not nice. I'm gonna take your motorcycle. Bye, bitch. I'm gonna take your crossbow, too. Bye, bitch.
But, yeah, about Morgan and Carol, I love their, like, I'm not shipping them or anything like that, but...
You're not.
What?
You're not shipping them. I'm not shipping them.
But people are going to.
All it took was that one episode. I'm not even talking about this one. I'm talking about the one back with the bullshit with the wolves. And now we're here. A whole episode where Morgan and Carol literally spent the whole episode together. This shipping about to be real.
Yep.
Nothing is safe.
And I like their growing friendship that they're doing. I hope they develop that more. Carol in this episode
I wanted to give her a hug.
I
wanted to punch her, and at the same time, I wanted to hug her.
I wanted to hug her, but because I understand what people's... I don't get what people's saying. I do, but I don't at the same time. When people are saying this out of nowhere, but it came out of nowhere. But can you imagine if you killed all those people and suddenly coming back to you? You probably feel the same way. That, oh shit, I fucked up. I don't agree about the her wanting to die all of a sudden thing, but I don't know. It's just this whole thing kind of.
I hope they hurry and get her some medical attention. She got shot.
Really? She got shot in the arm and she got shot in the leg.
She got shot again.
And she already had a wound. Bleeding. She was already bleeding.
She was already hurt. And then she got shot twice.
Yo, when he shot her, I jumped. I was like,
I was so afraid that it was a headshot. I was so afraid.
It would have been a headshot. And me and Dee literally screamed, "Where is Morgan?" at the same time.
Onward, my trusty steed.
I was like, "Morgan, where are you? I know you're close. Get there now." And then he did, and I was like, yes.
Onward, my trusty white stallion. That moment when the black stallion was riding on top of a white stallion.
I was like, yes. Thank you, Morgan.
It was a horse, bro. I don't know. But, yeah, these two and their shipping fodder. It was nice seeing those two have a moment together. I'm not shipping them. I view it as like a mutual respect / rivalry type thing that they have going on.
Like a love-hate relationship.
Exactly. If they do pull some Jimmy Neutron shit and put these two together, better give me a good reason.
At least it's not Daryl.
And you better do a good job than you did with Rick and Michonne.
At least it's not Daryl.
Daryl would have made more sense.
It would have made more sense, but you're always talking about the age thing.
Exactly. It would have made more sense. That doesn't mean I want it. It would have made more sense than Morgan, but I still don't want that to happen. As I've stated previously numerous times, every person they try and ship Daryl with is either Michonne, too young, or too old. And in this case, taken, dead and too young, or too old and suicidal.
Yeah. Next is, I put Aaron on the list because...
Why are you here?
Why did he come?
Why are you here?
Like, everyone in that group, he is the... I get he went because he's really close with Maggie. He's wanted to be there for support. But it's just like, of all the people that they could have brought on this mission, they bring Aaron.
Why are you here? No one asked for you to be here. Why are you here?
Love Aaron.
Why are you here?
Stop. I get it. We get it. I love Aaron, but I just feel like he didn't need to be there. I knew why he was there, just for support for Maggie, but everyone that there was supporting for Maggie, and they actually needed to be there, so, yeah.
Why are you here?
Sasha and Abraham, I really hope they develop that relationship more, because I love it.
Oh, the way that they were talking was adorable.
I know. And the way Abraham tried to ask her, do you want to make a baby, is so fucking hilarious.
Do you want to make a baby? No, wait. Do you want to make some biscuits? You wanna make some pancakes? I got some biscuit in the back. Abraham and his speech patterns, I can't.
Abraham is like
bitch nuts.
It's so adorable because I feel like in a long time since his wife passed away, he really hasn't like talked to like a girl. Like he hasn't
like. I feel like I'm going to start saying bitch nuts.
Bitch nuts.
Just regularly saying bitch nuts. I'm gonna stub my toe on something and be like, ah, bitch nuts!
I love his one-liners. That's why I want him to see, I want him to go. Which is, I love his one-liners.
We always have Eugene.
True.
We always have Eugene. I don't know if they went to the same college of bizarre zombie apocalypse one-liners.
So Sasha and Abraham, they're adorable. I hope they develop that relationship a lot more. The Saviors. Fuck every last one of them. That's all I've said. Fuck every last one of them. Because god damn it, I've never been so angry at a group of people before in my life. They got more and fucking creative as every time they ran into them, it was more creative
squad. And
more
squad.
Yo, that second to last one.
Wall of Walkers. Squad.
No, that was crazy with the Michonne's braids and Daryl's arrow in his jacket. That fucked me up so bad.
Okay, there were three things that was going through my head this whole time. Number one, Saviors. We got a sick person in the back. Damn you.
Really?
We're trying to get the fuck out of here. And you're just in the way. Number one. Number two. Damn, Rick.
You.
Bet you mad as shit now, aren't you? Bet you hurt now, aren't you?
We will talk about that when we get to that ending. Oh my god.
Oh shit. Oh, these Saviors blocking. Fuck, is you hurt? Is you hurt, my boy? Grimes, is you hurt? They realized how grimy the Grimes was, and now they hurt. And the third thing, all of you are idiots. I don't mean the Saviors, I mean all you people in the RV. I realized Maggie had to get somewhere. I realized that. Other than Gabriel, who's defending Alexandria?
I was gonna say Spencer.
Fucking
Zach. Asking like, oh, if they show up, you wanna make some kind of deal? Bye.
That's like asking, oh god, an evil villain just showed up in Timmy Turner's world. Who's gonna save the day? Timmy's dead. What the fuck is that nigga doing? But honestly, that's what I was screaming this whole episode when they started piling people up into the RV. I was like, okay, Rick, that makes sense. That's fine.
I was doing that too.
All right, that's fine. We need somebody to drive the RV. All right. Okay, we got Maggie there. All right, we're good.
Sasha. At first, I was asking, why is she there? But then I'm like, oh, wait, I forgot. She's sick. They're trying to get her to the hilltop.
I was like, we gotta get her to the hilltop. Yeah, all right, Rick, all right, that's fine. Abraham, need somebody to drive. All right, that's fine. Sasha, why are you here? Aaron, why are you here? Eugene, why are you here? Carl, why the fuck are you here?
Oh, we're gonna get to that.
Carl, why the flying fish fuck are you here? But literally, just seeing all these people pile into this RV made me so angry. Because literally, they're scattered. Morgan and Kara are off in who knows where.
Mm-hmm.
You got Glenn, Michonne, and Daryl, who got snatched in the last episode. And Rosita, who got snatched in the last episode. We don't know where the fuck they are. And now you guys decide you want to all go off together on a little camping trip, knowing that
They don't even know they were captured.
They just know that they're gone. Assuming.
And Tara and Heath are gone.
Assuming that they're looking for Carol. Everybody is divided right now. And you decide you want to take the rest of your new civilization's strongest defenders to go on a trip to the equivalent of the school nurse? You ain't leaving.
I think they only did that. They only did that to raise the stakes. They only did that to raise the stakes because the fact that everyone, all their strongest players, are gone from Alexandria. Everyone's scattered all over the place. And now the fact that everyone has pretty much been captured minus Carol and Morgan. And Keith and Tara. We don't know what the fuck happened to those two. So I think that was the point of the whole thing.
But I get it. Like, I know for plot reasons that's why they took everybody. But it's just, that's the equivalent of having, say the Avengers were having some sort of crisis. The Avengers are having some sort of crisis. Thor's off somewhere. Hulk's off somewhere. Black Widow, Hawkeye are off somewhere. And then you got Iron Man, Steve, just going to do, Falcon, going to do shit. And then Ant-Man with them, just going off to do shit. And who do they leave to defend Avengers Tower? Fucking Maria Hill. God forbid Loki or Ultron or the Masters of Evil decided, herp derp derp, guess whose tower this is now, bitches? All your strongest defenders, your strongest players are gone. Just gone. Literally, you gave up your queen, your knight, your rook, all your strong pieces. You got a whole other squad ready to fight you. And what you got defending your king right now? A bunch of pawns. Pawns don't do shit for me.
Okay, before we get this guy started even more with all of these
dumbass niggas.
So about that asshole saver, that one asshole saver.
That one prick. Who's the ass?
And Dwight.
He was a
When I saw ass. His face, I was like, fuck you and everything you stand for.
I love how when they were backing up from the RV the first time, he had the nerve to wave goodbye. Before kicking the nigga on the ground. Just like,
oh my god, that poor man.
He was getting tortured all for the sake of somebody making a point. And I'm like, damn.
That poor man.
Damn. He got kicked. He got dragged.
They spray painted him.
They spray painted him to set him on fire.
And they hung him.
They hung him in front of a fire.
In front of everyone.
They hung him in front of people. These saviors, just in general,
are no joke.
Wall of walkers, ambush shooting in the trees.
They cut half of Michonne's hair off and put her on a walker.
They cut Michonne's hair off and put her clothes on a walker to prove a point. Left the arrow in Daryl's and his vest on a walker to prove a point.
They burned logs.
They burned logs. These weren't logs. These were whole trees. These were big. You know what kind of machinery they need to have to be able to cut down that much lumber that efficiently and that quickly for the purpose of blocking off a road to then set it on fire? Like, what was y'all doing? What do you have?
They were trying to scare them. They were messing with them. That's what I thought. You know that movie from the 1970s called The Warriors? And that dude with the bottles? He was like, I really don't want to do it because I'm really not good at it. But the whole point of that is to taunt them. It's to mess with them.
It's a form of warfare. Messing with your enemy's head. I can get that.
Oh, here's a perfect example. Remember that episode of Archer when they were on the spacecraft and then Barry showed up and he did that thing with the bottles?
Right.
Yeah, that's what they were doing.
This is Barry's an ass. Fuck Barry. Fuck Bionic Barry especially.
I love Barry.
Barry can
I love
I'm not gonna go that far. But anyway. Anyway, yes, we watch Archer now. You know this.
Yes, I love Barry so much. He's
don't know if we're doing Archer videos. I doubt.
I mean, season 7. I just watched the season premiere of season 7, which was pretty good. I doubt we're gonna do that.
I still need to finish season 6.
Yes, you do.
There was this whole thing in me not watching Archer for obvious emotional reasons.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway.
Well, let's get to Eugene. I love you, Eugene. I love you so much. I do. I think he's a really good asset to the group. He's really smart. He knows how to make bullets. So that's a really good thing. I didn't agree with him taking the van by himself, though. Knew that was not going to end well. As much as I love that scene between him and Abraham, that scene had me in tears. That whole thing had me in tears. But I was just like, this is not going to end well at all.
Well, for starters, that scene had me believing that Eugene was about to check. He was about to check. But then at the same time, I respect your decision, Eugene. I see why you did it. I see why you all thought it was a good plan. In all honesty,
it was really smart.
Initially, I would assume it was a good plan too. But y'all forgot how many of these niggas there were.
I don't even think they realized how many they were.
They were stopped 3 different times. No, wait, 4 different times.
5.
5 different times they were stopped by a squad of niggas. And it wasn't the same niggas every time.
Mm-hmm.
So they know there's a lot of these motherfuckers. So I don't know what made you believe.
I think they were just trying to have hope. Because I know they had to get Maggie there. And the scene with him and Rick, Maggie and Rick, when they were still in the RV, they were talking about, Rick was saying that if long as we have each other, we can get through anything. Not knowing at the time that, dude. They were just really naive. I understand that they were just, they're trying to get her there. They're trying to be hopeful, like, we're going to do this. Like, we are going to get, we've been through all this shit. What's the difference between that and this? I don't think they realized how deep this was until they met Negan.
We've been through so much shit. Deactivated lasers with my dick now. Anyway.
Then we already talked about Morgan, so we can cross it out. And now, the ending. I want to start from when they went into the woods with Maggie to the end. That whole sequence had me shaking. I have never felt that much stress, anxiety, fear in my life. I've never felt that fear in my life watching a TV show.
Honestly, Walking Dead, as a show, one of its drawing points is that as bad as things get, no matter how bad things get, you always feel like there's going to be some ray of hope, some extra little spark of happiness, mm-hmm. some way to get out of the situation that they're in. For once, I don't see it. Like, they already said that this season finale was going to be the darkest one that we've had. And right now, I believe it. Because this is the first time where I've ever seen these people in a situation where I honestly felt like they can't get out of it the way they are right now.
They could.
They can't.
They were surrounded.
With Terminus, it was different. With the Governor, it was different. Because they could have fought it off. With the Laboratory, it was different because they left.
With the wolves, that was different.
With the wolves, it was different. Because they fought them all off, or they just left. With the farm burning to the ground, they just left.
Mm-hmm.
It was different.
With the prison being, you know...
With the prison being overrun, everybody left.
Mm-hmm.
It's a different. They fought hard, and then they eventually had to leave. Losing something, but still living to fight another day, mm-hmm. is just a continuous thing in The Walking Dead. Here, this episode was the first time where I was put in a situation where I, honest to God, believed anyone here could die.
Mm-hmm.
There is no way out of this right now. And the sad part is, this is the emotional stuff in The Walking Dead that I love, first mm-hmm. of all. But I've never seen it this bad in the media of Walking Dead before.
The best thing about this scene for me was Rick himself. Rick he was didn't say a word.
Terrifying.
That is the first time I've seen. I mean, I've seen Rick scared before, but this is the first time I've seen him terrified.
We've seen Rick scared. We've seen Rick broken. We've seen Rick sad. But in all of those times, Rick was able to rally himself together, at least the littlest bit, and find a way to get him and his out of this situation. This is the first time where he, honest to God, sees that there is no way out and he's stuck. And that
he said one thing. He said one thing when Negan was going near Carl. That's when he said something. But during that whole time, he didn't say a word.
He was quiet. He was sweating bullets. He was shaking.
It was like he was on the verge of tears.
I was shaking with him. Mm-hmm. I was shaking with him. This is just.
Whew. It was so hard to watch.
Even Carl was handling this situation better than his dad was.
Bruh. I feel like after this situation, Carl is not going to look at his dad the same. Because I know Carl. Like, dude, when they were telling him to kneel down, Rick, I would have been like, Rick, I was like literally saying the whole time, get down. Get down. Give him your shit. Give them your shit. Because I was with Rick in that situation. I would have gave him my shit. I would have did exactly what they said. But the fact that Carl was not listening at first, he was just standing there. He was looking at his dad like, what are you doing? And Rick was looking at him like, get down. Like, there's no way out of this. Get down. And then he finally did it. And Carl looked at Negan, was like,
I don't even think Carl's going to be mad at his dad. I think Carl's going to be mad at other people now. Because he watched his dad get broken down just by sheer fear. Like you said, it took a minute for them to get down. Mm-hmm. But then when his knees made contact with that dirt, he had given up. He was done. Mm-hmm. Like, as of right now, everyone here is just broken. This ending, whether it be comics, whether it be the Telltale Games, I haven't felt this level of helplessness before. Like, ever. Even when you're put in situations in the games where people are dying, or you're trapped, or you're captured, this is the first time I've ever felt like, oh my god, there's no way out of this.
Mm-hmm. And there was no way out of that situation. They had to do what they were saying, or they would be dead. And Negan's introduction was probably the greatest introduction of a character ever. Did he come out of their RV?
Yes.
Okay. That was awesome.
Negan's a savage.
See, yes, he is a savage. But I couldn't even appreciate his performance because I was just scared the whole time. Negan scared me. He made me shake. Because I knew exactly what he was going to do. And I just kept hearing him talk. I was just like, oh my god, they're so fucked right now. They're so fucked right now.
That's why.
And he was right. Technically, Negan was right. Because you killed my people. I sent more people to kill you. But yet you killed them too. And then I sent more people to kill you. And then you killed them too. So you know what? Gotta kill one of you guys.
Honestly, me being afraid is part of the reason why I love Negan. Like, in all honesty, for my introduction alone, I already like Negan more than the governor.
Yes.
I already like Negan more than the governor.
And
governor
he was only cool. On screen for 6 minutes.
Governor was cool, but I already like Negan more than the governor.
And he was on screen for 6 minutes. And he's already better than
the
governor.
Because the thing is, when I saw the governor, when we met the governor, we knew he was going to be a bad guy. He was gonna be bad. I never viewed the governor as a genuine threat. Mm-hmm. I just didn't. He looked like that stereotypical bad guy that you watched on a Saturday morning cartoon with his eye patch and his family issues. And then Negan comes strolling out of this trailer, talking this big game, and he backed it up.
And he was only on screen for 6 minutes.
And he was hilarious the whole time.
Yes, he was funny, but I didn't laugh because I was just afraid to laugh.
I was scared, but then there were moments where I just had to laugh.
When he called Carl a little serial killer, I was like, he did not just call him a little serial killer. But at the same time, I was just really scared. I was like, oh my god.
If he gets in the way, just feed him his son the other eye.
Oh my god.
I was like, did this man just say to feed this man his son's other eye? Savage.
The writers of the show were not playing when they said this scene was going to be the most intense scene of the show. They were not playing, and they delivered. They delivered.
I love Negan. I'm looking forward to seeing more of him. I am looking forward to seeing more of him, but I'm not looking forward to seeing more of him for obvious reasons.
Mm-hmm.
Now we got to get to the biggie. The elephant in the room that we've been drastically avoiding somewhat this whole video.
Mm-hmm.
The actual ending scene. For season 6.
The eeny, meeny, miny, mo. That entire scene had me in tears.
That was the scariest game of eeny,
meeny, miny, mo.
When this nigga had... At first I was terrified. But then when this nigga had the nerve to add on, my mother told
right?
me. I was like, you... Bitch, you already torturing these people. Why do you need to add more?
He literally added two words. When he stopped at one person, he said, and my. And then he went to another person. And then before he said the last word, he just kept going. And the editing was all over the place. I was like, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god.
He was just going everywhere.
Yeah.
And then he stopped. And it's just like, damn, AMC, you really about to do this. You really about to kill a whole vital member of this squad. And we not about to see who it is until October. Are you serious, AMC?
Are you fucking kidding?
Are you serious right now? This is almost as bad as the 3 month scare.
Of Glenn.
It was almost as bad as the Glenn scare. It was almost as bad as the 4 month telltale scare of I thought you were dead, when we didn't know that apparently a past cast member was alive and we thought they was dead, and apparently they were alive, and we spent 4 months racking our brains of who it was that might be alive. Only here, it's a lot harder to figure this one out. The angle it was shot, there's no way you're seeing shit.
Exactly. They purposely did that. Because in the beginning, you could be like, my heart was pounding when he was going eeny, meeny, miny, moe. I thought he was going to stop at that. But then when he kept going, I was like, oh... shit.
Woohoo! Taking it like a chance! I was like, damn!
I was like, oh my god.
Well, for starters, one thing we can get out of the way, whoever it is that he did hit...
He hit hard.
They ain't getting out of this.
He hit hard.
Whoever he hit is dead.
Mm-hmm.
Whoever he hit is guaranteed dead. Home run, guaranteed dead. There's no question.
He hit hard.
There's no question of who he hit is dead. He got hit hard with this bat.
Mm-hmm.
And the thing is, the worst part is, we didn't really hear that many background reactions either. So we can't even base it off of that.
But then again, I'm pretty sure when you get hit in the head like that, your hearing is kind of off. But then again, he could hear Negan. But Negan was like in front of him.
I'm not even just talking about Negan. Like, I didn't hear screams from anybody else in the squad. No screams, no concerns.
I think if they did that, then you would automatically know who it probably you would
exactly.
know who it was.
So we can't even guess or we literally are in a position where we just have to wait to see who got slaughtered. Like literally, no matter who it was, we're guaranteed to feel hurt this October.
Mm-hmm.
Like the only person that might not feel as bad is Aaron. Just because Aaron hasn't gotten as built up as everyone else here. I'm still feel bad. That was brutal and kind of fucked up.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, it's like, oh, it was just you. Damn. None of my overly main homies is dead.
If they did do that, that would piss a lot of people off.
Oh, yeah, because it was a waste of suspense.
Mm-hmm.
And a waste of a scene.
So pretty much this ending was the most crazy, terrifying,
emotional
ending we've ever had in The Walking Dead.
Just cliffhangers.
Just these cliffhangers, man. But I don't. It was smart, but it was just annoying, the fact that we have to wait.
Oh no, it was very smart in terms of cinematography and in terms of making sure people come back to watch. It was very smart.
Mm-hmm.
However, it pissed a lot of people off. I'm slightly irritated. I know why they did it, but I'm slightly irritated. And now, all right. For our big question that we usually do.
Oh, before that, I actually want to go at each character who was there and have a yes or a no if they're the one dead and why you would think they are dead and why you don't think they are dead. So we'll start with Carl. Yes or no?
No.
Why?
There's no reason to kill him here.
True.
Like, other than Negan just...
And he is the future of the show.
Even with Negan, for some reason, just not having affiliation with Carl, I see no reason with them killing Carl here. I just don't understand. I wouldn't see any reason killing Carl here.
Alright, Eugene. I say it's a possibility.
It's a possibility. It's a possibility, it's Eugene.
Rosita. Yeah. Oh, sorry.
Big heartfelt speeches usually mean setups for death. Mm-hmm. So there's a possibility it could be Eugene. Rosita, I doubt it.
I doubt it too.
I doubt it.
Abraham.
Maybe.
He's a possibility as well.
Abraham is
because
a maybe.
He said that you're taking it like a champ, and I feel like the only person who would do that is Abraham, and he did offer himself up.
Abraham or Daryl.
Or Daryl. I was gonna say Daryl next.
Abraham or Daryl. Or Rick.
Or Rick.
Rick's not dying because main character immunity.
Mm-hmm.
I think Daryl's not dying because fan immunity. Alright, basically the characters that I feel are 100% safe right now in this situation are Rick, Daryl, Michonne, and Carl. Everyone else, and maybe Maggie because she's pregnant. Mm-hmm. Maybe. Everyone else I feel as though is on the chopping block right now.
I think it's Glenn.
I think it's Glenn.
If it is Glenn, I'll be really upset, but...
If we're going canonically by the comic, then here would be the time where we say Glenn, say goodbye.
Can you imagine the season 7 opener? It starts with that exact same moment, but from a different perspective.
Just watching Glenn getting his face beaten. I was already hard enough to stomach in the comics, God forbid.
I felt sick to my stomach that during that whole scene.
I was just like, oh wow, they got blood running on the camera, okay. Yeah. Could you not?
I felt sick to my stomach. I was really holding. I was like, oh my god, I can't do this.
Could you not? Of everyone there, I feel as though it's Glenn. Everyone else either A, has immense fan or plot immunity, or B, not enough has happened, or in terms of a reasoning, for them to be dead. Mm-hmm. Not to mention, if this show was going to kill someone and make this big of a deal about it, they want it to be somebody that will leave an impact. They don't want to just randomly kill people. Mm-hmm. It's going to be somebody that's going to be important. Which means, in my opinion, I feel like it's going to be one of the starting six.
Either Glenn or Daryl.
I feel like it's either going to be Glenn or Daryl.
I don't want to see any of them die, but if that's how it is, and it's not gonna keep me from stop watching the show. But if it is how it is. Like,
I don't want to see Daryl or Glenn die. If Glenn dies, I'll be hurt, but I won't be shocked. And if Daryl dies, I'll be hurt and severely shocked. Mm-hmm. It's just like, wow, they actually did it. It's just one of those things that you never thought that this show would have the balls to do.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, wow, you actually killed your fan hype. You really ended Daryl's life. Damn.
I don't think AMC will risk that.
Look at you, AMC. You actually had the balls to kill them. You had the balls to kill your fans. Damn.
This video is going on a long time. That's like an hour long. It was going to be an hour long, so... So pretty much season 7 is going to be great, especially in the beginning. It sucks that we have to wait a long ass time for it to happen, but hopefully, if we can actually do this, Remember we talked about doing past seasons?
Right.
So, I actually want to start doing that. I actually started making thumbnails for them shit, too. I don't know. If you want to start it next week, then that'd be awesome. It'll give us something to do in the meantime.
Right.
So you didn't want to do it?
Yes.
Okay. So, I have to take notes on, and I probably rewatch season one. I'm sure you're gonna do the same thing.
Yeah, most likely, because it's been a while. It's been a long.
So, yeah, this was season six, and we're also gonna do other episodes, like the past episodes of season six too. But we're gonna do get season one and just go in chronological order, pretty much.
Right.
So yeah, this was season six. I love the finale. I love the episode before that. I really hope that they can blow us away with the season seven premiere. And this is gonna be, you know, a long wait, but it's what happens with great shows. They go on long waits.
I have internal pain. I have internal pain because of these episodes. I'm sad. Hey, also, big round of applause for Autumn, because this is her first October waiting for this.
Oh, yes, most definitely. And I'm going to have to deal with this.
She's become new to the fandom, so this is her first time waiting for that next season till October like the rest of us.
It had to be this
one. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I'll be okay. I'll be all right. Will I be all right?
Maybe. You might be. Maybe.
Oh, boy.
It's going to be that one Sunday where we're sitting here excited as shit for nothing.
Damn. I'm going to have to get used to that.
You going
to
sit up here on this couch?
Wait, there is fear.
There is fear.
And I just might rewatch season one. Just to give me something to watch.
We're going
to
do fear at some point, aren't we?
No. It's not that big of, a show for me.
No.
I don't give a shit. I really don't.
What happens if you rewatch it and you end up liking it a lot more than you thought you would?
Maybe. Because I really want to get these Walking Dead videos out of the way first.
Right.
And since Fear is going to be airing during the summer, I'd rather not just...
If we give enough of a shit, we will do Fear at a later date.
Yes.
If we care enough. If we care enough, we will do Fear at a later date. Maybe other Walking Dead stuff. But, you know... Here we are now.
Yeah, but
feeling sad.
We are very sad.
Final. Any final things you want to say before this hiatus from new Walking Dead shit?
Season seven. Robert Kirkman. Scott Gimple. Do not disappoint me with this fucking opener. Show us who died, so we can get this big weight off our chests, and have us cry. And be sad for a bit, and then move on. Okay? Just give us that. And stop with the fucking cliffhangers. I know why you have cliffhangers. I'm just saying. Don't do another one like that, please.
That hurts. Walking Dead Season 7 opener. If they did it like they did this finale of Season 6, then I can live with that. Wait till like the end of the episode to show what happened and show who it was that took that L. I can live with that. Or if you want to show us right in the beginning, I can live with that too. Just don't dick around and make us wait like halfway through the season till we find out who's dead.
Oh, and don't do another Glenn thing like that again, any other character like that again.
Where we think they're dead for like a whole week. No, 2 weeks.
Not even.
Because the episode after that didn't show what happened to Glenn. We had to wait a little longer.
Don't do that again.
They might. I mean, they already tried it again with Daryl.
But see, that wasn't even a long wait, though.
It wasn't, because it was next week. For the big question at the end, I shouldn't really need to say what this is, because everyone's going to be asking it. Who do you think bit the dust? Who do you think was the homie who got a nice, juicy kiss from Lucille? Leave it down below in the comments.
Uh-huh.
We actually want to read and are curious about who you think might have died.
Yep.
And your reasonings for why.
Uh-huh. And we will see you guys with our season one recap videos, and you know, season 2, 3, 4, 5, and half of season 6. And then we will start up again in season 7 in October.
7, a lucky number. 7. It's not a lucky number for one of those guys.
Bruh. And
ding, ding.
And thank you for watching, and please subscribe to my channel and for the more of these awesome videos. And I will see you guys soon. Well, we will see you guys soon.
Fare thee well. Subscribe to her channel.
Please do.
Subscribe! Subscribe, bitch! Nah, but seriously, we do this for the fun.
Mm-hmm. Bye, guys.
Laters.